the new movie that's just coming out, Cherie, Michelle Pfeiffer stars as a woman who's made a career out of seducing the rich and powerful. Oh, good for her. Until she meets her match, the young Rupert Friend. Wow, take a look.
The garden smells beautiful this evening.
It's the rose acacia.
Gorgeous, fun movie.
This is a Barbara movie. This is really, yeah.
This is no.
She would like to be that courtesan.
No, you look at a 19-year-old say that's me.
Michelle Pfeiffer and Rupert Friend. On you, the mother of teenagers, a happily married woman. So you heard us talking about the term cougar, the older woman. So how do you feel about that?
I'm not fond of that term.
No. Because?
I don't get terribly upset about it. I just think it's kind of irritating. Well, I mean, I know Joy disagrees, but it does seem as if it's part of the double standard. You know, it just seems to me that men are sugar daddies, and I mean, I think there's a difference between a sugar daddy and a lech.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And
well, the sugar daddy pays.
Yeah.
Well, in this movie, so do you.
And you know, and I think cougar has this sort of predatory connotation to it. It's like our talons come out or something, and you know.
Instead, you are what in this film? You're not a cougar. You're.
I look at it as a finishing school.
Okay.
I mean, she does kind of save his life, really. You know, I mean, he's just incredibly self-destructive, and she sort of takes him in and under her wing, and sort of
other parts of her,
and
well.
ushers him into adulthood, takes him off of his mother's hands because she's. He's making her crazy and spending all of her money.
It's the way it used to be. Remember, we talked about this ages ago. Women, fathers would bring their sons to women.
She gets him off of drugs, and she gets him to stop drinking.
It's like a one-woman rehab center.
That's right. It was the original rehab.
But, Rupert, I want to ask you about something in real life. Is it true that you don't own a television set?
That's true, yeah.
You miss debates, you miss footage of Katrina and of Iran. You're a young actor. Why don't you own a television set?
News from the internet, really.
Right.
Oh, so it's all the internet. So it's just that it's a different generation. Did you ever own a television set?
Not in my adult life, no.
Do you Hulu?
I may kill myself.
No, no, no.
Okay. It's a website where you can...
What is that?
Essentially, like you can.
Website.
Yeah, if you do like TV on the web, online.
Oh, interesting.
You know, you and your girlfriend Keira Knightley are constantly being pursued by the paparazzi. Mm. I see that a lot. And I read somewhere that you said that you know you would like to take them on, the paparazzi, and you give credit to anybody who would smack them down.
I got in a lot of trouble for saying that.
Did you really? Yeah. Why? But they're very aggressive, so.
Yeah, I think, you know, when particularly young women are followed by aggressive, strange men, it's frightening, you know.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I think we should try and maybe look at the controls on that a little bit.
So that's the thing about it, the aggressive men, like the Princess Diana syndrome.
Yeah, it's stalking. Mm-hmm.
Well, the only difference between a stalker and a paparazzi is you put a camera around your neck and then all of a sudden it's legal.
Yeah. Mm.
Well, Michelle, I wanted to ask you about this movie, Cherie. And you play this breathtaking beauty who's a courtesan. And you're seeing your career slowly coming to an end because you are getting older.
Of a certain age.
Of a certain...
I think that's how they describe it.
Oh, okay. Of a certain age. I got it, girl. There you go.
You're a fantastic wardrobe.
And
beautiful.
But which it seems like that's what Hollywood does. You know, women get to a certain age and Hollywood tries to discard. I mean, was there anything in this that was relatable in taking on this character?
You got this gig, so apparently you're still hot.
That's right.
Well, I think that overall, I mean, it's sort of hard to tell because overall there are fewer movies being made. I don't know really what the numbers are, but it's some, you know, astounding. There's 30% of the movies are being made that were being made, I think, 10 or 15 years ago. And I think all actors are kind of feeling it. I think there are fewer roles. It did seem for a while.
Fewer romances and fewer roles
and
for women.
Fewer dramas, and but fewer for men, too. My point is that there are fewer, you know, with reality TV, and there's just...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but do you think men of a certain age have the same problem as women of a certain age?
For sure not.
But there's only five of them. I mean, when you really think of it, there's only five guys of a certain age that are working. Most actors are scratching trying to get something.
Well, right. They're television. A lot of the actors go into television and do wonderful work.
Well, because
the Brits really do TV great. Well, I mean,
he,
I think
he doesn't watch it, so
he said
Well, I'm going to ask Rupert. You said there were some things that were lost in translation when you were filming. Is that right? It was like the American English.
Yeah, the scene where Michelle's having a massage, and I wanted to. Hit her on the butt, and I asked if I could, and Michelle said, "Yeah, you can smack my fanny all you like." And in England, a fanny is a very different thing.
Yes.
What's the fanny in England? Wait a minute, we're gonna find out what the fanny is.
In America, the fanny is the middle of a woman at the back. In England, it's the middle of a woman at the front.
But when I said it and that look on his face, I realized I had said something terrible.
So which fanny did you smack? Yeah, that would be oversharing.
Did you like the sex scenes, by the way? Very lurid sex scenes.
Did I like them?
Yeah, did you like them?
Wow!
Simple yes or no.
How you doing?
Yeah.
You're looking good. Well,
the guy played a Nazi in the last movie. This is a step up.
Well, listen, if you want to see sex scenes, if you want to see the fanny, if you want to see Rupert and Michelle, we want to tell you that Cherie...
His fanny, not...
his fanny, not her fanny, but she's got a cute fanny. Nevertheless, Cherie is in theaters June 26th. We'll be right back with Shirley Jones and Marty.